Greetings, viewers. Eric the Car Guy here, and yes, I am interrupting this video in a different form before it gets started, and you're asking yourself, why, Eric, why? Why is the shop dark? Why are you wearing a Humble Mechanic shirt? As far as Humble Mechanic goes, I'll put a link to his channel in the description. If you have any troubles with VWs, I suggest you go check him out. But the reason for the interruption is I wanted to let you know that this video is not going to play out the way most Eric the Car Guy videos have played out in the past, so I'm giving you a little bit of forewarning. Additionally, I make a mistake in this video, a pretty crucial mistake that makes this video a heck of a lot longer than it was intended to be. It was originally supposed to be just me installing the new calipers on the new differential that I just installed into the Fairmont there behind me. As you will see, things didn't quite work out as planned. Now, some of you may notice my mistake and pause the video and start with typing away, "Eric, you're doing it wrong." I get that a lot. It's part of the job. But I just ask that you wait till it plays out at the end because I am aware of the issue and the brakes on the Fairmont are working fine. That being said, there is one other note that I'd like to pass along to you before we get started, and that is that I refer to the splash shield as a backing plate in this video, and that is incorrect. It is a splash shield, not a backing plate, and some of you may note that, but I just want you to know that I'm aware, but sometimes as you're working and you're narrating and you're doing all these things, well, you say things that you don't necessarily mean. This is one of those times. I'm gonna catch up with you at the end. We'll summarize everything that happened in the video, but for now, get to watching, and I'll see you at the end. Greetings, viewers, Eric the Car Guy. In today's episode of our Fairmont project, we will be installing our rear brakes. So awesome, so awesome. I have a plan for the parking brake on this vehicle. This won't work. This was for the original drum brakes. So I'm not going to be able to use this cable. I'm also not going to be able to use the cables that were supplied with the kit that I got for this whole rear end setup here. Therefore, I've come up with a plan that I'm not going to cover in this video. So this video will not cover the parking brake section. For now, I'm going to tie this up out of the way. If I just let the cables hang underneath, well, that's exactly what they'll do, and I don't really want that. So my thought is I'll just tie this up for now. And hopefully won't rattle around too much. I have purchased backing plates to go into here. Here is the part number for this backing plate. I'll also list it in the description for you. From what I'm seeing, this backing plate will go in here something like this. I'm wondering if it has to actually go behind. If it does have to go behind like this, I'm gonna have to clip these tabs. But if it goes in here like this on this side, we're good. I played around with fitting these. As you might have noticed, these are for a 94 through 04 Mustang. With the looks of everything, I like these on the inside better. They're closer to the rotor when on the inside as opposed to being on the outside. The only thing I keep coming back to that I don't like are these tabs. I had to come up with my own fasteners, and I think they're actually 6x1. Seems like it'll be an easy enough alteration. I'm sure on the 94 through 04 Mustang, this tab has some significance, but it doesn't to me here. I do both sides. These aren't marked side for side, so you can use them on either side. I'm gonna clean off the disc with a little bit of brake clean. Soap and water is the ideal thing to use, but brake clean works. I have a rust inhibitor on the outside that needs to go away. To hold the disc in place while I install the caliper, I got a trick. Let's take an old front wheel drive axle nut and a lug nut. That'll help hold the rotor on while we're doing the rest of our work. Got my new caliper. New bolts was something else that I had to get. I think we're 12x1 that you need to attach these to the brackets. So it didn't come with these fasteners. I had to come up with these fasteners. I also got some lock washers to go on these fasteners to make sure everything stays in place. Gonna take out the foamy. It's weird everything going together being new. I like it. I can get used to this. Hook up my brake line. Got a new banjo bolt with new washers. To prepare for the bleeding I'm doing, I'm just gonna pull the cap off. Actually knock the bleeder loose and open it for now. I can start by gravity bleeding everything by doing it this way. Just like the other side, I'm gonna start by tying the parking brake cable up. I didn't wanna run this without a backing plate. My kit did not come with a backing plate, so I had to purchase these, or backing plates. So I had to purchase these separate. And I'm glad I did, because they help keep debris and stuff off the disc. I'm noticing something as I'm assembling this. There is zero clearance in here between the rotor. Now, it's not making contact, but it's way closer than I feel comfortable having it. So therefore, I'm gonna take that lock washer that I've got underneath the bolt head and put it in between the bracket and the caliper to try to space this thing out and move it over just a little bit, because this is just too close. Okay, let's see if this works. So I'm gonna take that washer and put it in between the caliper and the mounting point. I'll be honest, a lock washer is not going to be my first choice in this application, just a regular washer. I'm liking that so much better. The caliper floats, so the caliper doesn't matter, but I don't want the bracket coming in contact with a moving rotor. Install the brake line. Way better. I've got cameraman Brian in the car. Gonna bleed the brakes out on both sides till I got no air coming out. All right, Brian, pump it up. Ooh, I'm already starting to see fluid. Let's do the other side. Pump it up. Hold it. All right, I'm starting to see fluid, but I want to check the master cylinder. Cannot let that thing run dry. All right, pump it. How's that feeling?
Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not consistent.
No more air coming out that I can see. At least on this side, and on the other side for that matter. How's it feel?
I don't know, I don't like it. So what do I know?
Well, off camera, Brian and I ran a whole bottle of brake fluid through this entire system. There's no air coming out of back here, yet the brake pedal is pretty much junk. There's some more stuff that I need to install, I believe, and that would be this trick proportioning valve, also a new master cylinder. There's also this little funky brake line that goes along with this proportioning valve bypass, because basically what I'm doing is I'm bypassing the proportioning valve. It appears that I cannot just, I mean, I've looked around, I can't find any leaks or anything. So it appears that I've got to finish installing the rest of the braking system in order for me to get a brake pedal, in order for me to have brakes. The way the system is set up, it's set up for drum brakes. It's not set up for disc brakes. This shows you the installation of the rear calipers and all that other stuff that's there. I did find in the kit that there were fasteners for the backing plate, but the kit did not include backing plates. So that's where we are on that. And it did include some of the other fasteners, including the fasteners that hold down the rear calipers. Once again, links in the description to that and additional information. Don't worry, this isn't over. We'll get it going and stopping. I've had a moment to think. I'm not ready to give up just yet. Rather than installing all those parts, such as the master cylinder, this adjustable proportioning valve that I have before me, this bypass, all this stuff, I'm reading through the instructions, and one of the main things in the instructions is bypassing the proportioning valve. The proportioning valve is a valve that proportions the amount of brake pressure that goes between the front and rear brakes. I'm going to remove it completely. In fact, that's part of what I have to do anyway. I'm just wondering if I remove it completely now and leave my old master cylinder, leave everything intact, install none of this stuff, send equal pressure to both the front and rear wheels, what I'll end up with. Should be interesting. And all I need to do is install this plug and gut the proportioning valve. Oh, and the whole reason I'm doing this, I want to drive it. I want to try out my new gears. I want to see what they're like. And I got wheels and tires all put together. It's been a long time. It's time to drive it. I want to drive it. Here goes nothing. It's a 3/4 plug on the end of it. And I found that an 18 millimeter wrench will hold this in place while I knock this loose. I've got a pan underneath to catch any goo coming out. I may be better off with a 6-point socket, or I'm gonna round that thing off. Where'd my wrench go? There's a spring behind here. Stuff may come flying out. And I've got the plug ready. I didn't see any washer, I didn't see nothing like that. I'm gonna try to do this quickly. Yeah, there's an O-ring on the end of it. Let me see if I can find an O-ring for this before I go further, because I want this, the less time I spend with brake fluid leaking out, the less I have to bleed out the air. I don't want to reuse the O-ring. I found an O-ring on the end of that before I unscrewed it all the way. I went through my stash of O-rings and parts and I found one. I think this is gonna work. Hope it's gonna work. Stuff should come flying out any second. Yeah, maybe not. Go. I don't feel anything else up in there. Install my plug. Let's clean it up and try the bleeding again. All right, pump it up. Yeah, only a little bit's come out so far. I'll try the other side just for the heck of it. All right, pump it up. I'm not getting any air, but I'm not getting really any pressure.
It now has resistance.
All right, well, guess we're starting to get somewhere. All right, pump it up. Let's try the other side, see what happens. You seem to get some result out of the front there. A really different size bleeder, you're gonna go there with it. Kingdom for a wrench that fits. I mean, I'm running out of wrench sizes here. I wonder what the heck I did before. I probably vice gripped it. Darn it.
So what's going on, Eric?
When last we left, Eric and Brian, they were trying to bleed brakes. Well, we weren't having a lot of success with that, and it's the second day of not having success with that. So we gutted the proportioning valve. However, I just removed it and found this little rubber gasket thing, which probably went on the end of this, was still wedged up in there. So I'm thinking that this was causing the problem. I've also removed the master cylinder to try to make sure that it was functioning properly, and it is. You can see it's bench bled now. This is the back brakes, this is the front, so large reservoir for the front. Anyway, the back comes out first, and then the front. So those are good. And it's been sitting here sort of bench bleeding into my trash can this whole time. So I'm feverishly trying to get the proportioning valve back on here, and I'll get the, well, it's back on now. I just need to tie everything down and reinstall the master cylinder. I'm hoping when I switch the pedals over for the Mustang that this master cylinder works. I've got some work cut out for me with the brakes with this, if I'm honest. Because of the build I'm doing, I don't know if I'm gonna run power brakes or not. Power brakes are really nice sometimes, but this thing has never had power brakes. And it's the first car I've had without, modern-ish car that I've had without power brakes. I honestly like the way it feels. I mean, you can throttle the brakes is the only way I can describe it. There's no disconnect between pushing the pedal and what's happening with the brakes. And I'm not saying it's like that, it's just really difficult to describe. It's like a direct connection between you and the brakes. Now, over a period of time, it's gonna work your leg really hard, may wear you out. So if I'm in the racetrack and I'm doing that all day, power brakes would probably be a good thing. But if I can simplify things and just run a master cylinder on here as opposed to running a master and a booster, I've got it over there, master and booster if I need it. And I may have to run that anyway. But if I don't have to, I don't have to. Right now I need to get the master back on here and get all these lines hooked back up, attempt another bleed now that all the stuff is out of this proportioning valve, and see where we're at. I had to disconnect this master from under the dash. So this master, here's one of the main differences. You can see it right out of the gate. This master has a rod that goes into the back. This master has a rod attached to the back. Differences in technology for sure. And I'm sorry I haven't given you the play-by-play on this, but I wasn't really sure where this was going. I just kind of wanted to figure it out. And talking about it and working on it at the same time does not always work out for figuring, at least for me. We're just trying to get a pedal. Brian says there's no brake pedal to speak of. All I want to do right now is just take it out for a drive and try the rear end. Still got plenty more work to do, for sure. But I want to try, you know, see if I can reap the fruits of my labor, at least for one item. And if I can, and I can enjoy and bask in that glory for only a moment, I will be happy. But it seems like there are obstacles. I was originally thinking there was something wrong with the master cylinder. I now do not believe that to be the case. I think the master's fine. I just think it was that little piece of rubber in the proportioning valve that was sometimes blocking off flow, sometimes not. Either way, it's no bueno. Let's play. What size are you? 7/16? Good guess, Eric. Things have taken a turn. So what's happened is we figured out the master cylinder's bad. It's not sending any pressure at all to the rear wheels. I think it was old, rusty on the inside. It tore up the seal, and it's sometimes sending pressure, sometimes not sending pressure, and I'm done going insane. Well, I'm already insane, but I'm done making it worse. Made the determination that, okay, the master cylinder's bad. The 86 Mustang has a master cylinder on it, but it's got power brakes. This Fairmont does not have power brakes. Tried to compare the two up, they don't quite fit. So now I'm going to fit the new master cylinder to this whole system because the new master cylinder fits in the brake booster that's over there. There's just a lot going on. So in other words, I'm taking this master cylinder out. I'm gonna go and take the brake booster out of the 86 with the new master cylinder and put it into this. And I haven't put the proportioning valve in or anything yet. I just want to hook this up so I can go for a drive and try out my new rear end. That's all I want to do. I'll worry about the other stuff later, but at least the master cylinder will be installed. Whatever. Four bolts hold this thing in up underneath the dash. I'm in a rush. I want to get it done. So four bolts around the brake pedal. Look for them. Ugh. Brake booster. New master cylinder, like a glove. I mean, like a glove. The idea is for this to take the place of this. And if you look at the distance from here to here, as far as where the loops and everything are, they look relatively the same. I want to get this going now. Probably not a bad idea at some point, maybe take this, clean it up, paint it. Not today. Today I wanna roll. Ew, gross. That's been there since 1979. I'm just gonna move these brake lines. I just need to loosen them a little bit and they'll move out of the way. I just had them loose a minute ago because I had this whole proportioning valve off of here. And I may need to, well, I'll probably take them off yet just to see how they fit inside the new master cylinder. This way I don't run the risk of damaging them. Let's start with this guy. Brian had a good question. Will this all fit? Yes. I just need to make lines that go down to there. I'm gonna have to bench bleed this first also, but it'll do. And then I just gotta worry about coming up with a vacuum line to go over there so that we can run the power brake part of it. Whoops, I forgot. Booster's in. Now, need to figure out how to make lines to connect between the master and the proportion valve. That one won't go into there. This isn't quite threading in. And that's unfortunate. So I'm gonna have to come up with a fitting that does thread in. Making brake lines is not a problem. Yeah, this one doesn't seem to wanna fit into here either. Don't know why I'm doing this here. Yeah, these threads, not compatible. There was stuff in the kit. There's some interesting information that I cut. It's like a snowflake. The front has got to go down to the front of the proportioning valve. And this guy, this funky guy here, looks like he is going to come out like this. Yeah, that fits. And that apparently will go down into the back part of the proportioning valve. Okay, that part is solved. Then it looks like I've just got to come up with some way to go from this front down to the proportioning valve in the front. And I'm scratching my head going, I wonder if any of these fittings will work. That's not that. So it looks like just one line needs to go down from here to here. And I don't know what line is supposed to go into there, because that can't be just left open. Let's go over to the car. With a little bending, I can make it happen. Who goes here? If that goes to that front, this goes to the other side, the other front. I know because I made that line. I'm thinking this is the front brakes like I suspected. So this will go down into there. And we know that goes there. And we know that'll go there. If I disconnect that from the proportioning valve, then what's supposed to go in its place? I need to read some instructions.
This whole brake line setup that they got in here is goofy.
It makes zero sense. Therefore, I'm going to completely ignore this whole T-fitting thing because, well, it ain't never gonna work.
This thing, on this application, because there's an empty hole that doesn't go anywhere. I mean, on there they show it going to a brake line, but if I unplug any brake lines from the proportioning valve, we're gonna have a massive hole in the system. So I'm just gonna run this line to here, this line to here, call it a day.
Pretty, no, but it'll work a far sight better than what they had. I wonder if this will be long enough. Seriously doubt it. Neither one of those will work. New solution for that.
This is a weird one, and I don't know why Ford made this weird fitting in here, but they got a pretty weird fitting in here that I had to go and find. And I gotta tell you, O'Reilly's just saved my bacon tonight. So I'm able to thread that in, and this is gonna be long enough to reach over and get to that other fitting, which I hope is the same. If not, I have, now I gotta change this one. Yeah, gotta change that fitting. Well, that's not a problem. I can very easily do that. Change that to something that actually works. So that being all I have to do, no problem. I can get that done right now. All right, I had to swap one fitting. I don't mind that I had to swap one fitting, because I could. So now we just gotta bend it. I'm gonna start up here. And I've bent much prettier lines. I'm not proud of these. I may go back at some point, I don't know. This is barely long enough. Almost like I should have started from down there. That is ugly, but it will work. I can just see people now. Eric, who did your brake lines? I let some kid do it. We're bench bleeding this master cylinder away from making this a reality. It's bled. Eric, you're doing it wrong.
What's that electrical?
It is a brake fluid level sensor. So if the brake fluid gets low, closes a switch, turns a light on your dash. This vehicle was never equipped with such a thing. Therefore, it means nothing to me. Seriously, who was it that bent these lines? Someday we'll go back and make this right. Someday. Not today. Master and power brakes. Now these are power brakes. See if I can run a vacuum line to this after I clean it up. I'm not worried about getting stuff on the K-member. That's going bye-bye. Okay, it's officially power brakes. I've been through it, man. Bleeding these brakes, got nothing coming out the rears, beating myself up, trying to figure out what the heck is going on. And I used different words, trust me. I used a lot of different words and I said them very loudly. Didn't help. Made me feel a little better. Blew off some steam. Anyway, still no pressure to the rear brakes. What changed since I started doing this? Gutted the proportioning valve. Because I gutted the proportioning valve, I changed the whole system. And now, there is no pressure going to those back brakes. And I need pressure going to those back brakes in order for any of this to work like it's supposed to. Therefore, we're going to have to install that proportioning valve they provided us with. If not, well, we're going nowhere fast. Oh, and by the way, I removed the master cylinder. I measured the push rod coming out of the booster. I measured the depth of the master cylinder, and they're like dead on perfect. So that's not an issue. That's what I just finished doing. Then I read the instructions. Right over here is the block leading to the rear brakes. This is what we need to replace with our new proportioning valve. Go get my catch pan and put it underneath here. There's an in and an out. In is coming in from over here and out is going back into the firewall. If I'm lucky, this will thread right in. Am I lucky? Yes, for that one. Feel a lot better if this thing started tightening up. It's not tightening up at all. It's calling into question the fact that it had two fittings that were in the box with it. Don't forget to install these. They came in the box. They're the things that actually go to the brake lines. Okay, let's try this now. Eric, why are you taking the calipers off? Because I think I figured out the reason why Brian and I have been sitting here for 3 hours trying to bleed these brakes out. Calipers are on the wrong side. Brian slapped me. He should have slapped me harder. I would have. And that may be the reason why they didn't seat in here well. That may be the reason why I had to put this washer that's about to fall out in the way I did. But it is most certainly the reason. If you look, bleeders on the bottom. Bleeders aren't supposed to be on the bottom. They're supposed to be on the top. Air goes up. All my fault. All my fault. Yeah, they do fit a lot better this way.
You need that washer?
I need it on the outside. It's still pretty close, but it doesn't seem as bad. Still, that looks awfully close. Like, too close. It just looks like it needs that washer. I'm not happy. That was a lot of effort. A lot of effort. All right, looks like there's enough in the master cylinder. Let's give it a try. Wheels are finally going on. It's just strange and bizarre. The hang-ups, like the hang-ups with the differential, the hang-ups with the brakes. All my fault with the brakes, okay? I accept 100% of the responsibility on that. But I'm ready to be done with this part so that I could rip the engine and transmission out and get ready to put a killer engine in this car. And I mean killer engine. By the time you see this, you already know it's a turbo. I've been keeping it a secret on my end. So you haven't seen it yet, but I have. It's sitting in a box right behind you. Having the differential done, having the brakes done, rear suspension. And once I get the engine and transmission out, I'll be able to swap the K-member and I'll be able to do the front suspension. That's why I'm not doing it now, because this K-member over here on the floor, that's what holds the engine in, and that's got the front suspension attached to it. So I can't do anything until that's in there to the front. Now, spacing of these calipers still looks pretty tight to me. I'm still a little nervous about that. I'm not hearing them touching, so I'll let it go for now. But if it becomes an issue, I know what the issue is. So far, we got a brake pedal and it stops the rear. So we have, in essence, solved the issue with the brakes. Well, viewers, I screwed up, as you could plainly see. So there's no need to jump in the comments and tell me I'm doing it wrong. I was already aware. Now, Eric, why did you leave all those mistakes and things in the video? You could have just edited them out. Well, I don't want you to think that I'm perfect, and I'm far from it. I also don't want you to be under the impression that when you're doing custom work like this, when you're doing hot rodding, so to speak, that things will go to plan, because more often than not, they don't. In this particular case, it was my own, I don't necessarily want to say ignorance, because I know the way it's supposed to work. I know to put calipers on the correct way. I just, for whatever reason, didn't register that, and I was looking at it. We even had a shot of the bleeder valve being upside down. And it just didn't register in my head at the time. It did, however, later, during the course of bleeding brakes, I was going along and I just said, Brian, stop. I know what's wrong. And I realized that the bleeder valves were not pointing up. Air goes up, so the bleeders need to be at the top of the calipers. Live and learn. And I'm hoping that's what you take away from this video. Not so much that Eric the Car Guy is an idiot, because I already know that, so you don't need to tell me. But it's that we make mistakes, and it's how we deal with those mistakes that make all the difference. So if you're gonna be hot rodding, things like that, don't expect things to go to plan. Try to take a step back and look for the obvious, because so oftentimes that's where the answer lies. But everything went back together. If you're curious, I did have to put those washers in between the caliper bracket and the mounting. to get that same clear. I had that same problem where the mounting bracket was actually coming in contact with the rotor. Since I've done that, it's fine. I've taken it out for a drive. You'll either see that in a subsequent video or I'll link it in the description and you can go right there and watch it now. As you'll see, brakes work fine. Some of you may have looked at the rotors and seen the way the slots and everything were pointed and thought that I'd put them on incorrectly. Know that they were marked left and right. There was an R and an L on the rotors and I did put them on the correct side. Sorry I didn't mention that during the course of the video. I was kind of distracted at the time, but I did put them on the correct side. That is the way they're supposed to be. And if you're curious, the driver's side is the left side, passenger side is the right side. So left and right is from sitting in the driver's seat. Just saying. Anyway, I've taken up enough of your time. Thank you for sharing it. Other than that, if you have automotive questions, I'm going to ask you to head over to EricTheCarGuy.com, link in the description to that. Also, any other important information that might pertain to this video will also be linked there, so please check the description for additional information. Google+, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, if you wish to connect with me socially. Be safe, have fun, stay dirty. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.